One Indian who is making an exit is Sania Mirza. Mirza was dumped out of the singles by her Romanian opponent, Sorana.
The same story was repeated in Wimbledon on Wednesday when Indian ace and world number 85 Sania Mirza crashed out in the second round. It took her Romanian opponent Sorana an hour and 22 minutes to end Mirza's singles campaign with a 6-4-6-4 scoreline. Sania Mirza hit two aces and so did her opponent. However, she committed two more double faults in the first set than Sorana. Sania also committed 18 unforced errors compared to Sorana's 5. Sania had more winners to her credit, but won only 31 points in the first set as compared to 39 earned by Sorana Sirstia.
Again, another very solid service game from Sorana Kirstea, the number 28 seed. That's all she needed to take this first set, 6-4.
In the second set, Sania started off well but failed to keep up the good show and allowed her opponent to come back into the game. Sania managed 15 winners to Sorana's 13, but even had 12 unforced errors to her name. Sania hit just one ace and made three double faults.
In terms of confidence, I'm feeling good. Even today, you know, I felt like I could beat her. It was just a few points. So and she's 28 in the world, and, you know, that's the cream of the crop, basically. So, yeah, I'm just, I have doubles and mixed here, and then, you know, looking forward to the hard court season.
Sania will now look to put up a better show in doubles, where she and her Taipei partner, Chia Jung Chuang, will take on Americans Jill Krabas and Carly Gullickson.
India's Sania Mirza crashed out of Wimbledon on the third day of the tournament, once again unable to go beyond the second round. 30 unforced errors by Mirza saw the game go in favour of Romanian opponent Sorana Kirstea, who actually happens to be Mirza's friend off-court. But sentiments aside, Mirza now needs to take a hard look at her game, which she probably is doing right now, up her ante, maybe change a few things if she ever hopes to break the second round jinx. This is Simrit Kuman for Times Now in London.